basics. The basics are going up to, at first we just put a square piece into the lake. We cut away. There are different ways of doing it. You normally use these big one. Just a minute. Do you use this one normally?
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. This is, I also have it at home, and we use it for big scale columns up to 4 meter length. 4 meter, it's about from you up to here. It's quite useful. The difference between this tool, I like to work very much with this one tool. But if you have big corners, this one gives you shorter shavings and is much more pleasant at the beginning, because the shavings are just, it's cutting down like this. This one gives much longer ones. So if you want to start spindle turning with a flat one, this shallow gouge, you have to cut off the corners at first. With this one, you can just start and go ahead like this. But it works fine, both work fine. It's just the question what you are used to use. Have a look. I start like this. And I cut it down like, start at the outside. Once more. Once more. We go to this side. Now we have to start not like this. You must never start on this on the outside. Then you break off pieces which may injure you. So be careful. Always cut from the inside to the outside. That's it. Now it's not dangerous anymore. Now to get the right cut. If you keep your tools like this and you keep it straight in, you get trouble. It's just like this. It looks horrible, you know. Have a look. Now, I keep it upwards. And it cuts wonderfully, doesn't it? So, how to find the right angle? It's always a question that people ask, how can I find the right angle to do spindle work? Listen, that's one thing. I don't know. And you don't have to know. You have to do the following thing. Put your tools on the top like this, and draw it back again, and in good touch with your piece. And when it starts to cut, you have the right. Because if I, it's so confusing if I would tell you, you have to keep it in 50 degrees. I would say, where does it start? 15 degrees when I have my rest long, waist down or up, upraised. You know, it's so confusing. Forget it. Forget it. Just do it like this. Put it up like this. Right back. Now it cuts one. That's the right angle. So easy it is. Now. And if I keep it like this, it doesn't work. Have a look. It cuts like this. And now I'm going up to the right position. Have a look. How the shavings are coming.
perspective.
And the same we do with a jute chisel. Go a little bit closer, a little bit more high up, like this. What's the right angle? I don't know. And you probably don't. Just put it on the top. Put it down, and when it starts to cut, that's it! And it works wonderfully. The true chisel, isn't that, it's absolutely an advantage. Made a medical cut bone in the black ribs. It's easier, and it doesn't, and you don't get a catch as easy as if it is straight on. Both work fine. It's a question if you are really familiar with it or not. Now, we do it once more. Have a look. You can drive it over like this. We have a wonderful cut. And we can do it the other way around. Or you could do it this way. It goes in all directions. It does. Training, and it doesn't take long time, and you will be successful. That could be my first training. It's always dangerous if you have tools, and metal tools and shocks close to you. You will push it in, and then you have to grind again. It's not pleasant. So, now, so far. If you want to go ahead with it, we can just make some marks. Next step. We tiny this. You can keep it like this, you can keep it like that. It doesn't matter. Underhand grip is more common in English-speaking countries, I've discovered. The German grip has always been like this. This one is a little bit more safe, more strong, but you can do it both ways. Just do it as you like to do it, like this. And the next step is to shape these pieces. Do a minute. What do you call it? Round stuff or something
beads,
like
leaves, beads,
beads,
food, and beads.
Okay. Okay, you put it on the top again, as I showed you with the big one, and you drive it down, and when it wipes, you just turn it around like this, and then you have the side, and then here, and there. And correct it the whole time. Try to do it with one cut altogether. It gives you a much better feeling, you know, that you manage the tools and in a proper way. So the same thing can be done with a huge chisel. Top. One, two, three, four, like this. The next step, and it's clean and okay. Well, you can certainly to do it much slower and to make it more correct and precisely. So just choose what you want. Now, the next thing is to make, what do you call a groove like this?
Cove.
The opposite.
Cove.
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 Cove. Cove. You know, I never have learned this English expression from many of these things. It's a problem actually. It's just the same as this one. But we start now on the top, on the side. At first we start like this, in this position. We go down and end up like that. From the top and end up like this. Now we start up like this and end up like that. Have a look. We start here. And you have to cut immediately from the other side, otherwise it will break out. So, have a look. One, two, and go down again, and here again, like this. The next one, always start at this. Did you say?
Can you raise up the camera a little bit to get it out of the letters?
Like that? There you go.
Actually lower it.
Yeah, yeah, raise the letters up.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah.
And have a look. You know, these pieces, it's very clean immediately. If you do it right, it has to be like this, you know. Absolutely, it's no problem at all if you just follow these rules I've shown you. Certainly there are individual abilities and you can do things in many ways. So, it's my way, it might be yours.
Works.
But this one works.
Works.
In any case, it has worked for nearly 50 years, so it should be okay.
Is it possible to cut a cove with a skew?
How?
Is it possible to cut a cove with a skew?
No. This is, it's possible, but it's inconvenient. If it's a longer one, yes. Like this, and then you have, you know, you can't get in like that, so you have to drive it down in this position. That's it. So you have to get in like this, you know, you can't start in the normal position. This is not possible. Otherwise, you probably would, it would catch it and come back like a rocket, you know? So, this is absolutely basic. Now, if you want to make all kinds of profiles, and you have just to start. The next one actually is a cuff and it's a carnice. Do you also call it carnice? If you combine a cuff
OG.
With a...
OG.
Hmm?
OG.
OG, you call it.
Yeah. You got the one and the other.
Yeah. OG.
OG mode.
Never heard of it. It looks like this. because you go up and down and can see properly both techniques. Have a look, it looks like this. We go just, well, we do the same on this side now. It's about there, I would say. You have to just define a little bit, just have a look at it. Spindle turning needs training, and just to do it the right way, to get it lightly and things like that. So, I actually noticed that people who have trained quite a lot of spindle training feel more safe in wood turning. With other things also, because they you can, if you don't use the tools in a right way, you get catches the whole time, and then you learn how to put it in the right, the tools in the right position, you know, and that's very important. So, now, actually, I wanted to show you some different things. We are soon going over to make two spheres, or one in any case, because in a sphere you can show it exactly how to work. If you don't work really in an accurate way, it's not a sphere, you know. So, and it trains your eyes to see precisely the size and the shape. It's a good training. It's a good training. We always do it when I have a course. People have to learn to turn spheres. It gives you a lot of fun. And at the end, I'm quite sure you are making all your bones there, which you use in the garden. Oh, your wife and your children will appreciate it, I tell you. It's really fun if you do it, and it's wonderful to have a really fine, big sphere, you know. So that's the next thing we are going to do. Well, I wanted to show you something, but I'm not quite sure if it works, because I should have had a piece of a branch of a tree, you know, and wet wood. I don't have it. I'm not quite sure if this works, but I will show. Just a moment. I have to bond it with this one, I think. And the handles to these, for these two. Thank you. is to say, with these trucks, you need at least a wife and two children to mount the thing.
I used to be do that.
Me too.
So. Start like that. If you do so, it will get a screw and it runs over. Have a look. Like this. It's not pleasant. So just put it in the right position and it works fine. And when you've got this one, you can just turn it around the head and then you can stick it in. Works fine. That's very important. You start like this. First, good. Now I have the right position. And you don't need any inches like that. So it's a handle. Well, it's a bunch. For your wife, you know. You can do so many fine things. This doesn't work properly because you have to have the center in the middle. Then you can lift the fibers elegantly up, you know. In all sizes, you can make big ones, small ones. So there is one. So if you just, you can have a lot of fun. Spindle turning gives you enormous possibilities. It's not used yet too much, but you know, you can just make a lot of such funny things. Use your imagination, and I'm quite sure you will have a lot of fun at home in your workshop. So, well, that's it. Let us go ahead with the next one, next project. And this is to these fairs. Mm-hmm. we use, we try to use this piece and make two spheres out of it immediately. So if you play it with one instead. It's the middle, you say. Now we do it in a way that we put it between the center because it's easier. You probably have seen it before. You can take a cylinder with the exact length, just put 2 or 3 millimeters in length in addition. But and then put it directly in chocks and turn down the first side and then remount it again in another chock. In a new one to do the opposite, and then. But I would say now it's easier to illustrate for you to make a bigger one and to put it between center immediately, and then the rest we just cut off afterwards. So we are going down to I would say 10.5 or something like that. And also keep your hand as you saw at first. Is coming against me if I use the underhand trick, you know, like this. I was trained when I was a young boy to keep it like this. Put your hand on it, put it on the rest, lift your hand up, and nothing is coming against your eyes. Nothing. It just comes out like this and goes down. It's perhaps not so spectacular as sometimes some demonstrators call. It's impressive, you know. Yeah. It's not this.
So. This should be good. Press the stop. Now, we got these sides. It's 11 centimeter. We mark it. We need a mark on this side to avoid doing these points like this. And we make a new one. Here. Like this. This will do it. Now we cut it in the middle. We take a little bit more, then I can take a bit more. That's better. Grips over if you like.
have it down to exactly 10 centimeters. Now, we use these signs exactly on this way, like this, and mark it. Take half of it, like this, and mark it again. That's a point. And as you know, when we now turn away these pieces on the outside of the line, and shape the square properly, turn it around with 90 degrees, mark it again, so that this line comes up in a little point in the front, and we take off all which is standing and bumping out, you know, it should be an absolutely perfect square. Also, there are different techniques. We could, for instance, mount it and make just a line with a two chisel and prove it down and then remount it. So there are many ways of doing it. And another one is to put it into these two points again. Then you have to find the exact, you have to divide it in six parts, you know, then you can put it, but then you get marks, which is not convenient and not nice. So another way of doing is to put it in a truck sideways, you know, the cylinder is going like this, and which you have turned out in a way. It looks like this, which is, and another one on this side, and then you can put in here, you put in
tailstock,
yes, and here, and you press it between it, but then you have to remount it the whole time to correct it, if you are doing it this way, but it works. So we are doing it quite in an easy way. It's probably the quickest one. Now let us have a look how we start to make a sphere. Many people start right. You mustn't start too close to the midline. If you do so, it's very difficult. So cut down at first on the side, like this. Then you cut down. And leave just 1 millimeter more in the length compared to this one. A straight line down. That should be sufficient. We do the same on the other side. Grind your tools like a field name, like this, and correct the same the same on both sides. If you're trying to unequal, it will not be the same shape on the other side. That's a problem usually. Down like this. And end up exactly. We do the same on these sides. And you can imagine that if I had trained this pointy on this side, like this, you know, it wouldn't do the same thing on this side. It wouldn't. Most trouble people have is not the piece and not the mind, but the tools for such things. But it is more than 3 millimeters difference. So we can just take a little bit more now before we take it down. We start here. And then we always drive down it with one cut. Next one, so that you can see it once more. It's a little bit too long, as you can see. We need it. If we make it too short, you know, and then we miss something for the sphere, you know, when we turn it around and mount again in a church. Now we do it the same with this one.
Can I ask a question while you're mounting?
Come on.
I noticed on your tools you have a flat bevel, but you don't use a round grindstone, you use a belt sander?
No, I use a normal grinder. Yeah. Have a look, it's concave. Just a little bit. Yeah. And this enables me, that's very important for me, it's very important. 3 weeks ago I was in Sweden and I'm teaching at a school. High school for a craftsman for 1 week each year. And somebody was allowed to use my tools for something special. And he returned it again, and I started to do some work. It didn't work at all. I was so confused. And at the end, I rarely get angry about something, I must admit, but I couldn't understand. And suddenly, I was so angry, and I said, who grinded my tools? You nearly couldn't see it, but it wasn't the same anymore. It's very strange. If you have done and grinded your tools for such a long time of your life, you notice immediately if somebody has done it in a different way. And how to grind these pieces? I never use a jig or something like that. Never used it in my life. All tools are grinded by free. How to do this? You put it on like this, exactly in the middle. You turn it around and when you turn it, and when you turn it, can you see it now?
Not yet.
Yeah, the grinder?
We're getting there. Right. Yeah, there you go.
Does it work? Okay.
Yeah.
When you turn it around, you move it at the same time, simultaneously out like this. Always take again and push it down like that. And this will give you the finger name grinding. Like that. Well, I don't want to do more. Because I want to save my tools, but have a look. It's clean and I haven't tried it out completely. I don't want to do it now, of course. But if somebody just does it for me, you know, it doesn't hurt the same. It doesn't. It's a pity. So.
How long was he in the hospital?
I wouldn't want to be in the same room.
I wouldn't even want to be in the same
company. Yeah. Start again. You just Let me cut it off. Use the little pieces. Be dangerous to keep it in a proper way. You can ensure it is seriously, so it's very difficult. But we can turn it over when we put it in a jar. Now, I do the same with this one. It's easier to work with outwards. The next step is to make the chapter and put it in. I have this enormous one. Because it works so quickly. I never use a face plate for light pieces. Well, if you have really heavy things, you have to mount it in a face plate because you need a lot of screws, otherwise it wouldn't come out. So, that is the hand. So now you can also see how it works with a shallow gouge to turn such pieces. Otherwise it's going to be a screw. Chuck is a good one. It's a really hard trip.
One way?
No? Yeah, yeah. I think so. Precisely over, and I normally say you have to make it about 3 millimeters smaller than the sphere, the right diameter. If you take 3 millimeter less, it works normally fine. And if you can't get it to fit properly, you just take off a little bit more. Two, three, like this. And we start to make it up. If I don't have this on my leg, I take just a little bit. Thank you. recommend at the end not to make it too smooth inside. Just rip it a little bit. It grips much better.
Were you just scraping that there? We couldn't see it now.
It grips much better.
It grooves in.
Just rough it up.
Yeah. And now you have to find the center point here. This is important to do a good job here. Then it works. I make the center line more visible like this. Have a look. Now, if you fail and don't get it into center, just make it like this. Have a look. Now you can see it. It's very easy to do it with that. Now you take a hammer or something else and keep your hand on the top. And then you just push it this way. Let us have a look what we... No, it's not. We take it down again. It's very useful to make a little bit exercise with it. If you can't get it out, you can remove it. Let us start again with it. We put it in like that. We turn it around like that. It's not so bad at the moment. I normally use a pen before I take it down from the spindle. Then it's much more easier. No, it's not so bad. Have a look. I think it's okay. We can leave it that way. You know. This is coming over like this. It's just a little bit. We can push it. Small. You can just once more. Just to show you how you can do it. Take the new side like this. If you draw this line immediately before you take it down, it's quite useful. Have a look now. It's half a millimeter out of center, so we leave it there. It's wet. This means it will shrink during 1 hour so much that it's not as fair anymore. No, it's okay. We leave it. Now, we just put it in place. A short one, if we have. No. That's okay. That's okay. And now you can see all which is standing over has to be removed. Can you see it? Is it possible for you to show it? It's a little bit unequal, with about 1 millimeter. It jumps up and down, and this has to be removed. Disappear here, just you have a field here in the middle where we have to take more and there too. We lower it a little bit. And then I can take a 2 chisel, just drive it carefully around like this. You can also feel it. It's very easy to feel. Remove it completely, but it's very difficult to get it clean if you use a scraper this way, because it's so wet down. But remove it, okay, like this, and put it in that way. And now it doesn't mean so much if you get it into the center, because this side is already finished. And it must come to the right position, just like this, finished. Next time, but not here. So, take it off. You can move it in all directions, you know, it could be, it doesn't matter which direction you choose. use them just to get it clean. And then if you use fine hardwood, you can polish it. It's so nice.
If you use dry wood.
Dry wood, yes.
The
chuck
wood.
Oh, yeah. No problem at all. No problem. If you work really in a precise way, you know, there's no problem at all. It fits so properly. You could turn out now a small hollow form of it. It's stable enough. Just you hit it in with your hand. It's incredible. It's such a perfect fit, you know. We take the next one, this one, and at first we have to make it a little bit bigger.
Johannes, where's the contact? Does the ball contact just a little bit inside the chuck? It's not the whole thing, is it?
No. No, this one doesn't have any influence on the feet. Nothing at all.
Just the outer edge.
You could just drive it straight down or a little bit cone, you know. It doesn't matter.
Just the outer edge.
Yeah. Absolutely. Just the inside doesn't mean anything.
So in other words, you need to cut all the time. You're a little deeper. I was just wondering how much of the percentage of the ball is happening.
This piece here instead of breaking it off with the tools. Have a look. It's less than 1 millimeter. You can see. There's nearly nothing.
Have you done this before?
I tell you, it's the first time.
Don't give him a bad time. He's the best cameraman we've ever had.
Okay.
It has been perfect.
Very good.
Camera work is.
A pipe, you know, a steel pipe, looks like this, and you sharpen it from the outside, like this, and just push it, put it on the top, and move it around, and it will be absolutely clean and absolutely straight. So this helps sometimes, especially it is used for ivory spheres and things like that.
What's the relationship between the size of the pipe and the size of the...
It doesn't matter. Okay. You can just use, use 2 inches thickness. Well, this is only if you have to make a lot of them,
right,
or special work. Otherwise, it's not enough to start with.
It will just...
Yeah.
And that's just to take any little imperfection down, right?
Yeah. Well, you also could use such a, what do you call it in English, sickling, what do you
scraper.
Call it?
Scraper.
It's only a scraper.
Yeah.
Okay. It sounds so simple.
Yeah.
You could use it this way if you have difficulty. Now, it doesn't work because it's wet here. But you feel it in this position, have a look, and then you can get it off. You have to make it clean and to remove the rest. But normally it should be sufficient to just with the 2 chisel. Just to go around and to get it like this. I just want to show you some different possibilities.
Pardon?
Now we have to have a look. We still can see here the line, and I have to remove just a little bit more. We use now this chisel. So we should get the patch grinder for the tool. Now we are going to the other side, we take it out, we use our rest because we don't have a hammer. Turn it around like this. That's sufficient. And just do the same on this side. And as you can see, it's half a millimeter out of shape, not more. Okay. That's it. It's gone.
Thank you so very much.
Much more pleasant.